Liver disease caused by the hepatitis B virus, referred to as HBV, can be either acute or chronic. The first serologic marker to appear in someone infected following exposure to HBV is hepatitis B surface antigen, referred to as HBsAg. HBsAg, shown by the red hatch line, can be detected on average 1 month after exposure to the virus, but can range from as early as 1 week to 9 weeks after exposure, and may precede the onset of symptoms by 1 to 2 months. Symptoms, when present, occur on average 12 weeks after exposure to HBV, with a range of 9 to 21 weeks. This period is noted by the green bar. When the serologic test for HBsAg is positive, HBV DNA can usually be detected in the patient's blood. The duration of detection of HBsAg and hence HBV DNA is variable. About 50% of patients will test negative for HBsAg and HBV DNA by 7 weeks after symptoms of acute illness have appeared. All patients who recover from an acute infection will be HBsAg and HBV DNA negative by 15 weeks after the appearance of symptoms. Hepatitis B E antigen, referred to as HBeAg, is usually detectable in patients with acute disease and is noted by the green bar. The presence of HBeAg in serum generally correlates with higher titers of virus and greater infectivity, while the presence of antibody to hepatitis B E antigen, referred to as anti-HBe, shown by the yellow bar, denotes lower levels of virus and thus less infectivity. A diagnosis of acute hepatitis B can be made on the basis of detection of IgM class antibody to hepatitis B core antigen, IgM anti-HBc. This serologic marker is depicted by the pink hatch line. IgM anti-HBc is usually detectable at the onset of symptoms and becomes undetectable within 6 to 9 months. Total antibody, IgM and IgG, to hepatitis B core antigen, referred to as total anti-HBC and illustrated by the purple hatch line, persists indefinitely as a marker of past infection. Antibody to hepatitis B surface antigen, referred to as anti-HBS, is depicted by the orange hatch line. Anti-HBs becomes detectable during convalescence and after the disappearance of HBsAg, and generally indicates recovery and immunity from reinfection. There is a period of time, often called the window period, which occurs after the disappearance of HBsAg and before the appearance of anti-HBs. During this window period, when using routine tests for diagnosis of acute hepatitis, IgM anti-HBC and total anti-HBC may be the only serologic markers present. There is also a period of time soon after exposure when these routine tests will find only the hepatitis marker HBsAg present. A person with chronic hepatitis B virus infection will have both hepatitis B surface antigen, HBsAg, shown in red, and total antibody to hepatitis B core antigen, total anti-HBC, shown in blue, persistently detectable by serologic testing throughout the duration of chronicity. HBV DNA will usually be detectable in serum as well, using a nucleic acid test, or NAT. Hepatitis B E antigen, HBeAg, shown in green, generally indicates higher levels of HBV DNA and thus greater infectivity. Presence of antibody to hepatitis B E antigen, anti-HBe, shown in purple, conveys just the opposite scenario. Chronic HBV infection is diagnosed when a patient has a positive serologic test result for either HBsAg or HBeAg or HBV DNA on at least 2 separate samples 6 months apart, or when a patient has a positive test for any one of these on a single sample and has a negative test for IgM anti-HBC. Successful vaccination against HBV infection results in production of anti-HBS, with seroprotection defined as an anti-HBS level of 10 milli-international units per milliliter or more 1 to 2 months after completion of the vaccination series. HBS-AG may be transiently positive for 2 to 3 weeks after vaccination, but this is clinically insignificant. A serologic test result of anti-HBS positive alone indicates immunity following vaccination with at least 3 doses of hepatitis B vaccine. Without repeated exposure to HBV, antibody levels will naturally decline over time. But immunity is likely maintained even if levels decline below 10 milli-international units per milliliter. This table summarizes the interpretation of serologic test results for HBV infection. Negative results for hepatitis B surface antigen, HBsAg, total antibody to hepatitis B core antigen, total anti-HBC, immunoglobulin M, IgM anti-HBC, and antibody to hepatitis B surface antigen, anti-HBS, should be interpreted as never infected and therefore susceptible. Positive HBsAg with the other 3 tests being negative indicates early acute infection, but could also indicate receipt of the vaccine within several weeks. This is a transient effect. Positive HBsAg, total anti-HBC, and IgM anti-HBC with negative anti-HBS indicates acute infection. As acute infection resolves, HBsAg will disappear, and before anti-HBS appears, both HBsAg and anti-HBS will be negative, while total anti-HBC and IgM anti-HBC will be positive. Negative HBsAg and IgM anti-HBC with positive total anti-HBC and anti-HBS indicates past infection with recovery and immunity to new infection. Positive HBsAg and total anti-HBC with IgM anti-HBC and anti-HBS negative indicates chronic infection. Total anti-HBC positive alone, with the other 3 negative, has several possible interpretations, including a false positive result and therefore susceptible. Past infection, resolved. Low-level chronic infection, and unlikely to be infectious, except under unusual circumstances involving direct percutaneous exposure to large quantities of blood, such as blood transfusion. Or passive transfer of anti-HBC to an infant from an infected mother. Anti-HBS alone should be detected following vaccination, as described previously, or may be detected for 3 to 6 months following receipt of hepatitis B immune globulin, HBIG, also commonly referred to as HBIG. This segment is now complete.